guys, and welcome to another video. If you're new here, my name's Lauren, and in today's video, I'm gonna show you guys the trends that I really love that I'm seeing on the spring 2020 runways and why I love those trends and how I'm styling them within my own wardrobe. So if that sounds good to you, just keep on watching. So I feel like in your normal like trend video that people are telling you kind of what others are seeing on the runway and from like magazines and whatnot, they're breaking down the trends that are incoming, whether they're actually functional or not. I can't tell you how many times I've seen someone in a video talking about trends saying, oh, this isn't really my style, but I'm gonna try it anyway. So that kind of bothers me because I feel like if you're just trying trends, you're kind of feeding that mindset of, oh, I'll just, you know, wear it for a couple seasons and then get rid of it. So for me, I like to look for trends that I'm into and I'm excited to wear, and maybe I've kind of had it in my head and I've just been waiting for them to become like more mainstream so they show up more in stores and I'm able to get my hands on it in maybe a really fun color or an interesting print and incorporating it into my wardrobe that I feel like it would already fit into. So today I'm going to talk about five trends that I feel like are on trend in the fact that I'm seeing them a lot on the runway, but also that I feel like aren't just gonna be here this season and then you're gonna wanna purge it the next season. These are design details and silhouettes that I feel like are more easily accessible now that they're on trend and that you can really get the wear out of and keep in your wardrobe for years to come. And I'm also gonna be styling an outfit that goes along with each trend. So the first trend I'm gonna talk about today is the tiered dress. And a tiered dress, just the basic silhouette, is usually very flowy and it usually has at least two tiers depending on how long the dress is. So I love this trend because I feel like it's a good mix of feminine and bohemian, and it's kind of got like a soft effortlessness that goes along with it. There are a couple of styles on the runway that really inspired me. The first is seeing a tiered dress in a baby doll silhouette. Short, like swingy, very easy and like ethereal sort of look. And the two designers that really did this in a standout way for me was Cynthia Rowley and C. The longer version that I loved was in like a classic black and white dot, very easy to wear and could easily be worn in so many seasons. You know, it's for spring 2020, but I feel like a black and white maxi dress could be worn in spring, summer, fall, and even winter with some tights and boots. The designers that really did that really well was Sync Accept. I'm not sure I'm saying that correctly. Please correct me in the comments if I say it wrong, any of these wrong. And then the final version that I really loved was by Lila Rose. I feel like this is the more like fashion forward version. It's not just a tiered dress. It's kind of got a little bit of like flair and elegance with the ruffle at each tier. And then that super pretty like washy tie-dye print, I feel like is so beautiful. And I just feel like this is something that someone could wear on a red carpet or just to like an event, a wedding. So this is just a way to do it in a more elevated way. The way I styled this is I started with my tiered baby doll dress from Target, from the Wild Fable line. And I wanted to kind of like edge it up because the way I had been seeing it was very like girly and sweet. So I styled it with my Zara kind of utility shirt jacket looking thing with embellishment on the back and on the pockets. And I felt like the colors really worked well together. And then I just threw on a brown ankle boot and I really like how it turned out. So the next trend I'm gonna talk about today is long sleeve maxi dresses, and I've been really waiting for this trend. Every time I see like a long sleeve maxi dress, I get excited because they're just like a staple in my wardrobe. I feel like they're so perfect to wear to work. For me, I'm covered and I have a little bit of like warmth because I'm wearing long sleeves and a long skirt, but it's just like a super feminine look. And also, I don't know about you guys, but whenever I wear like a long dress, I don't know, I feel like kind of like elegant and like a princessy, I don't know, super girly. I'm into it. So I just really love this trend in general. any print, any color, I would definitely just wear like a long sleeve maxi dress. I'm so into these. The ones that I saw on the runway that I really love, the first one is from Kate Spade. I would wear this right off the runway. I really love the silhouette. It looks really comfortable. It almost looks like a knit fabric. So it looks like it would be super easy, comfortable. You could wear it with sneakers. You could wear it with heels. Super versatile piece. The thing I love about this trend is there's so many different like versions and ways to take this long sleeve maxi silhouette and transform it into whatever aesthetic that you feel like is your style. So the Marc Jacobs version was super flowy and bohemian, and the Cynthia Raleigh version is super simple with color blocked and strong shoulders. And then I'm also loving like every single thing from the Celine show. That super bohemian, gauzy, soft, like ruffly detail is really just like my vibe. I think that having like a long sleeve maxi dress with like kind of like a puff sleeve and just like feminine details is so fun and easy. Those are some of my favorites. I styled this trend in a very laid back way since all of the runway looks look very like polished and high fashion. I just wanted to kind of like take it back and make it more casual so that you can see how it can be dressed up and dressed down. So I just styled one of my favorite black maxi dresses from the Maison Jewels line at Macy's with a pair of yellow Converse and a black moto jacket. I think it's super easy and basic, but it still looks put together. So this next trend is more of like an incoming trend. So we haven't really seen it like a ton in stores, but I'm really excited about it. It's using sheer fabrics in interesting ways. So fabrics like organza and chiffon that you can see through, and just using them in not just like a sheer dress or a skirt, and using it in totally new and fun ways. So the first way that I saw this trend portrayed on the runway was from Chloe. She used a sheer textured fabric over a printed fabric, and I just think that's so interesting and so impactful, but so simple. Like, it just seems like a no-brainer. Of course, it's so easy to put a print underneath something sheer and have like a cool effect and texture and print and all that fun stuff. So I really loved how she did that. The next was from Nicole Miller. This was a really cool like illusion top. It was sheer, but using the ruffle detail, it was like covering all the important things to cover, but it was still like interesting and really wearable. The last one was definitely my favorite from Helmut Lang. Each piece was sheer, but it was such like an interesting silhouette, and that you to see a sheer fabric and you never see like sheer shorts or anything. So I loved the pocket detail, and it just like looked really cool and interesting on the model. I styled this trend with my favorite polka dot top from Sanctuary, and then I just tucked it into a pair of high-waisted H&M pants and some nude pumps. I love this outfit because it's sheer without being revealing. I feel like the print makes it a little more fun and playful. The fourth trend I want to talk about today is eyelet, and I feel like this is just like a classic fabric that everyone kind of wears in the summer. It's very girly and open and breezy and just exudes this just like feminine aesthetic. And so what I loved about this season is everybody was taking it to the next level and using it in different ways. So the first one that I loved seeing on the runway was by Erdem. And instead of just being your kind of standard white cotton, this one has all the yellow, and it brings like a playful element to the fabric. So I just love seeing it in different colors and having that playful element brought in instead of just being kind of like your classic white eyelet. So the next eyelet that I loved seeing was from Red Valentino, and I loved this oversized eyelet that they used. And I feel like seeing eyelet in a cute little set was really fun and new. I would definitely wear an eyelet set. I think that's so pretty, and it just like seems polished but still playful. The next piece was also from Red Valentino, and this one was the one I was most excited about. It was this eyelet jacket, and it almost looks like a rain jacket with the eyelet on the sleeve and the hem. So it really feels like bringing together function and femininity with this eyelet jacket. And you never see eyelet in anything other than like skirts or blouses or dresses. So it was really fun to see it in the jacket. So the way I styled this look for this trend was I started with one of the eyelet pieces that I have. I'm a really big fan of eyelet, and I actually grabbed this Rebecca Taylor eyelet skirt from when I was interning there, and I love this thing. I think it's so fun and pretty, and it's this nice bright pink color. So then I was like, all right, well then let's, if we're gonna use this like bright pink, we might as well have fun with it. So then I just paired it with a bright red blazer and a white t-shirt to have that like red pink color combo, and then I just finished it off with a red pair of heels. Just like got all the Blair Eady vibes, and I just love this look. The last trend that I'm seeing everywhere is high-waisted pleated trousers. And we've been seeing a high-waisted pant for a really long time in stores and on the runway, but I feel like now it's kind of taking more of like a vintage look in spring season with the big pleats and just like a super loose hip and thigh area and then tapered it at the leg. So the people that I feel like really showed this trend was Alberta Ferretti. Has a really beautiful pant. It's got this super big belt and the button detail at the cuff of the pant and these super deep pleats. I just think this is a really fun pant that is actually a star. Usually, you know, the top is the star of the outfit, but I feel like in this case, the pant could definitely be the main part of the look. So the next part of this trend is like you're seeing them in these bright, beautiful colors. So with Marc Jacobs, they showed a pair of teal high-waisted pleated pants, and then at Derek Lamb, they did this really beautiful yellow pair. So I feel like you're getting that really cool silhouette, and then you're taking it a step further and seeing it in these really bright colors. And then of course, you can't go wrong with a leather pant like Jason Wu did. I love this style, and I think taking this vintage silhouette and putting it in just like a sleek modern leather is so cool, and I really love that trend. So I styled this trend with my mini checked high-waisted pleated pants that I got in Portland last year. I really wanted them to be the star of the outfit, so I just styled it with a simple striped t-shirt and then a pair of menswear Oxfords from And Other Stories. I just wanted more of like a vintagey, relaxed vibe with these, but they could easily be dressed up with like a blouse and a heel. So that's definitely an option. All right, guys, those are the trends that I'm loving for spring 2020. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure you let me know in the comments what your favorite trend is. If you would wear any of these trends, just let me know down below. And if you like this video and you wanna see more style and trend videos from me, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you don't wanna miss any videos from me, make sure to subscribe. I put out new videos every Sunday, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.